Oh, yes. Where were we? Shouldn't have taken away the whole equation, but when we start, so I'm just going to use the going to use matrix and A, U, J, this minus of 1, the vector containing all of the displacements. So the problem here is that actually starting it. We also had the starting conditions over there, which are no longer here. Of x 0 equals f of x t of x 0 g of x. So here we only have J0, we don't have the negative. We only have, when this is 0, then this is 1, and we haven't solved for this. So, well, solution 1, S1, let's just replace this with a different differential. I, vector anymore, 1, x 0, this is this. Zero. And here we can basically just solve for U1. So time step 1. If you start from time step 0. I0 plus delta t g x I. Already have this, this is defined in the start. Or we could do a Taylor expansion. Start with I yeah, I forgot to mention the drawback of this. So only first order in time, not a condition. And the one we solved earlier was second order in time. So we're missing some accuracy there. 0, t, t, 0, plus this whole thing here. 2 factorial dt squared and x on 0 and t factorial and x I j again. J between 0 and 1 from the earlier one. And then if the second derivative f exists, so if exists t squared zero equals squared x sine 0 of xi. Inserting this.
Good.
X position t. 1. False. xi.
0, and then we can use.
There. Onto ending. This gets
I
row. We're doing something. This term here, based on the starting condition, c squared. This c squared wave equation itself. And we are also changing the equation starting condition. So, and then we will have the rest. 3 factorial. Yes. I'm looking for the starting condition. Okay. You could either just, well, use the definition of the time derivative of u here. And then you see that you just use directly. There. Yes. Where the x squared. Second lowest. Here? Ah, yes. The two there. Yeah, that's a wave equation directly. Yes. So this is just for the starting conditions in time. We need to figure out t1. You're starting at t0. Okay, what's that? Well, that's defined by starting condition f of x. The problem is that we also need t1. In order to start the equation. And a very easy way to do this is here. So there we get u at t1, then have this time derivative of the starting condition, that is g of x, just basically insert it. Problem here is that this approach will a u linear, big O of delta t. What I'm doing now is I'm trying to figure out a way of having the starting conditions that shall we have big O of delta t squared. There's some algebra and then point. What I've done here is I've Taylor evolved u at time t1, get this equation. And then I assume that the second derivative of the, well, the driving force that is starting, the force, for instance, f 2 times differentiated exists. That's an assumption. Okay? If I look at the wave equation, I see that I can do something this term here based on the function, this, the driving force. I can actually take the second derivative starting of the driving force as the starting point we used in it. So now I have something for this term. Okay, now I need some this term. And basically this term. And we also need to approximate f here. Again, we can a central operator there. with u at x I t1 equals x I 0. This one we know. That's from f directly. Plus delta t directly. This one goes to f I, oops, delta t at I plus squared to t squared factorial. Squared squared. So we end up one I plus T I squared U or tutorial same F I 1 minus I F I minus 1. Oop. Get 1 minus squared I squared 2 I 1 GI T. I. Now big O of squared. The better way of inserting source. Just a bit more complicated, but more accurate. In the animations I've done, I basically just use. It's a lot easier. If you look at the functions, I have used the Ricker wavelet. I have done a time derivative of it, so I basically get g. Then I can insert g there. Yes. Yes. But if you decrease it, then you decrease it for both of them. If dt is smaller, then this one will be better, but this one will also be better, but not as good. Yes, that makes sense. But to reiterate, I've used this in the code. You can basically just use this. And I haven't scaled it either, so I've just plus g of xi. because the scaling isn't really that important. This. Just vector. But runnable. We also have to look at the stability of the wave equation. Or was there questions before I move everything? There's a lot of decisions to make. So, stability. There's always some error in the numerical differentiation. Numerical differential. But we don't want this to go out of bounds. So this is of a certain magnitude that would just accumulate, and the solution will explode. Will accumulate and explode. As you saw with the fusion equation, when I didn't respect the stability criterions, just blew up. Just gave me nonsense or non-breads. So it's just exploded because the error is accumulating. What you really want to do is that the error is so small that it cancels itself out for each time step. But we won't go into details on like the theory behind stability. I'll just give you the results. But you are very encouraged to look at the results yourself. So for the wave equation, we have something called the TFL or Courant. Spell names correctly. Courant, Friedrich. Louis with criterion. CFL for short. L. And for the wave equation, R, again, T, O, delta x less than 1. If it's more than 1, we'll most probably float. But it's dependent on the wave velocity in the medium, also your time stepping, the device grid points. So you see you can't arbitrarily reduce delta t. You need to focus on. And according to theory, we'll get a stable. More stable solver. So an example. Hopefully work. Solving this wave equation for homogeneous media where we know the solution, the analytical solution. Example here is B squared XX. So this is a dimensionless wave equation. Have x go from 0 to 1. Same with time, goes from 0 to 1. Starting condition 0. B. So the endpoints. All times are stationary. We write it 0. X V of T 0. Zero. Okay, this can be solved analytically. And analytically, solution is B line pi x. Cosine t. So this is our benchmark. Next, need to pick grids. So delta x 0.1 e. And from the equation, U, in our case, R equal to 1, I hope. 5. This is basically what I write, not hide. That is F, so the starting condition here. Sine of pi times x, okay, that's fine. G of x, that's just 0. Starting condition. Dx, we pick that to be 0.1. D, we pick this to be 0.5. T equals 2. We already know the length. Time and space, that is 1. Then we need to figure out how many points we have. Well, x of n, so let's say n point dx, plus we have one extra point, 1, same in time, and we discretize the lin space. There it starts from 0, ends at the end position. And we have this amount of points, so nx. Calculate r squared. The cons r should be 1. So that's in the limit of what is acceptable. Okay. Solve this. Cons. It. Numerical solution. This. The error. Pull a bar to see it. This. Very low. In this case, we've actually been lucky with picking them. But we can see what happens if this r is less than or more than 1. What can I then? Well, a larger number. But it ran. Break, but the error is much, much higher. Also try with a smaller one. 5x, that actually is larger. So r is actually smaller, but the error larger. So you can't look at the R, figure out your error. You want your dx and d as possible. Could do. One more of them. And we see they'll have but there's also some structure. So this is basically just numerical noise now. And that is because in this case, we have been very lucky with delta t and delta x. Pick them like this. Ratio. Here. To machine. You want to check what the machine position is. MATLAB is 1. 2.2 times 10 to the power of minus 16. Is basically here. So, try to explain this. again. We're going to look at the discretized wave equation. This one by heart now. Okay, plus one. J. J minus one. I. T squared. C squared. I. Plus one. I. J. Then over four factorial t four U of X. Okay. Take it so. B squared. Four. Psi I. B. J. Plus. 6 factorial t squared t. F x I j n x four d x J. Right. I'll stop there. Terms. Okay. Again, studying the wave equation. Nowhere to be seen. We see that we have delta t squared t 4. Okay. Well, we can actually try to solve the wave equation. Squared. We will have vt squared of u. What I'm out. This x. Okay. See what I did there? Squared of u equals from the wave equation. Okay. I can rearrange all of these terms. T squared 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 I T A. I'm allowed to do this? I should be. Again, we apply the same trick. We get squared delta t squared x squared squared x y t j and 4 delta t 4 x multiply. Yep. This case. Over here. R squared, again, c squared delta t squared over x squared. In this example, 1. This okay to follow? Huh? Yeah. So this all follows. So what I've done here, I'm looking at the truncation error, and I'm basically just applying the wave equation to one of the terms, get an equality here. Now I'll show you why I've done this. Yes, and we know that this example, we have already chosen the delta x, delta t, z, such that this r squared equals 1, meaning that we have bias at squared delta t squared. And if you want, you can just and then we can look at so this one. And that's also the one I'm writing over here. T squared t power 4. U squared dx 4. So I'm basically looking this term. Okay. So using the there, this should be equal to c squared over oil. Squared. Four. I. J. Okay. So what is the assumption I have done here? The assumption I've done here is that first point in both time and space is that six I exactly u a
exactly?
That's the assumption done. But it also holds true. Okay. So this is the first error term. What is this equal to? This equal to this. 0. So the error just cancels out because we've picked this, these delta x and delta t in a good manner. And just cancels earlier out. And if you want extra homework, you can do this for the next term. So this 1 over 6 factorial. And see that it holds there also. So in this case, with these parameters, is 0. The only error we have is the numerical one. Oh, okay, four. Okay, yeah, that was actually what I was supposed to show. Questions? Tomorrow I'll do some more about convergence and stability, and also introduce the project. Talk a bit about the project and what I expect, and some difficulties and some assumptions for it to be easier to solve.